Thank you, sir. Sir is also having a lot of interest in wildlife photography, traveling, and he is a person, I can say that he is a truly a person who lives a life very close to the nature. Okay. And I can say that devoting so many years in the field of biodiversity, zoology, and forest conservation and all, we cannot have anyone other than sir to enlighten us with this today's webinar. Sir, it is an honor and privilege for us, sir, to have you with us today. I'm sure we will be enriched by this webinar. Over to you, Dr. Parvish Pandya. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's indeed a pleasure to be here amongst students and teachers of Commerce Faculty, Bookkeeping and Accountancy Department. Thakur College is not a new place for me. I have visited Thakur College several times. I have friends in the Zoology and Botany Department. And in fact, one of the trustees of Thakur College was a very dear teacher of mine. He is still in touch with me. And he is right now with the Rotary Club, and we are doing a lot of programs with them as well. Dr. Pradhan, if all of you know him. So I'm one of the favorite students of his, and we work on several instances together. I'm sure students of today's session must be wondering, why have our teachers arranged a program for bookkeeping and account students by a person who is going to talk about wildlife? What is the correlation between wildlife, bookkeeping, and accountancy? Why are we being faced with such a kind of a torture? So let me tell you all, students, we are all a part of this environment, and accountancy, bookkeeping, economics, every field, whether it is commerce, arts, music, culture, history, geography, everybody is concerned and is connected to the environment. When you become the future citizens, and when you are in the field of taking up jobs, there will be questions which will be asked to you, and they will ask you, what is the ethical practice that you are observing as far as environmental preservation and conservation is concerned? And that is where your knowledge about environment and how in economy, everything that you proceed with when you make, you know, kind of decisions, or when finances are being talked about, everybody is now talking about environmental concerns. So if you listen to my session, you will come to know how bookkeeping, accountancy, and environment are totally correlated. And without that, you would have been, missing out the opportunity to learn about these aspects. Without spending much time, I'm very happy that my photographs were shown earlier. I am a wildlife photographer myself and a judge for several competitions. And maybe students might also be interested to know that I sing. I've learned classical music for about 7 years, and I'm on Star Maker app, and I've recorded in the last pandemic more than 200 songs, but I'm only singing old Bollywood songs. Okay, so this is one more connection with nature that I have. Music cannot be disconnected with nature. Our music has originated from nature. So here is where I will now start sharing. Okay. First of all, I'd like to introduce the term. Everybody knows forest. Forest is the presence of trees, or even absence of trees. You call it as sparse forest. And what is livelihood? Livelihood means job opportunities, means of earning our income, or the way in which you can get material gains for your own survival. So we know something about forest. We know something about livelihood. Today, all of you are gaining a degree because all of you are interested in later on developing your own livelihood. That means earning money. So livelihood means a mechanism to earn money so that you can survive to buy your bread, butter, jam, and everything. Okay. So forest, we know livelihood. Sustaining people means to allow people who are around these areas or even our own communities, our own human beings. So sustaining them means to allow them to live for a very long period of time, not just 5 years, 10 years, but for several generations to come. So sustaining people and sustaining planet. We need to make sure that our planet, we don't have plan B for the planet. We have only one Earth and we have to survive on this Earth. We can't decide tomorrow that we have now enough. We have deteriorated this Earth. We have done all the problems on this Earth. We have created so much of garbage and everything. Now let's go to Mars and live there. No, that is not possible. There is no plan B for the planet Earth. Yahi ek srishti hai. Yahi ek dunya hai. Hame yahi pe rehna hai. Aur hame yahi pe usko theek karke rehna hai. Taki hum aur hamari aane wali nasl aur peedi bahut saalon tak yahan pe zinda reh sake. You all must have heard of the word ecosystem. What is ecosystem? Ecosystem is a group of living and non-living. You must have been taught about this word even in your EVS. Why I'm using this word, I'll let you know later on. Okay. So ecosystem could be a forest. Ecosystem could be a grassland. Ecosystem could be a lake. It could be a river. It could be a seashore. It could be the oceans. All these are ecosystems. What does that ecosystem have? It has living components. The living components could be plants, animals, and so on. And the non-living components, which could be light, temperature, pH, salinity, and all these, soil, for example. All these are a part of ecosystem. Now, when I talk about ecosystem, so forest is an important ecosystem. Every ecosystem gives us a service. This is the word that is today being talked about all over the world, okay? I'm going to come to this world and I'm going to talk about this from bookkeeping and accountancy word and your sphere of learning and understanding. So what is an ecosystem service? An ecosystem service is whatever the ecosystem gives us. You know, when we take service, you take service from the people who are going to save your building, from your fire, from your emergency, from your maid servants, from your grocer. You are taking service from them. All of you know the word service because in bookkeeping and accountancy, you use the word service. For your service, you pay some money. So when people give you a service, for example, if you have a security service, you pay the money, okay? In the same way, ecosystem is also giving us services. And these services, which ecosystem gives us, is nothing but it is equal to livelihood creation. I'm going to talk about in my lecture how ecosystem service is equal to livelihood creation. So once again, I repeat, what is livelihood creation? Livelihood creation means creating opportunities for us to earn money, for people to have jobs. Creating jobs is livelihood creation. So in other words, ecosystem service is going to create jobs. I repeat my sentence once again. Ecosystem services are going to create jobs, which means the forest is going to give you functions. The forest is going to give you some good things. And from those good things, you can create jobs. I hope this part is very clear. If not, I will repeat. The forest is giving us some functions. What are the functions of the forest? Very easily, I explained to my students also, all the functions of the forest are with the syllable F, with the pronunciation F. So what are the functions of the forest? Food, look at my words, all are with F, F. The fur in Hindi, okay, the fur. Forest gives you food, fodder, furniture, fiber, okay. Pharmacy, what is pharmacy? Medicines. Okay. So all this the forest is giving us. These are functions of the forest. And from this, we are creating livelihood. So the best thing that I have been doing in the projects since many years is creating livelihoods for the people of the forest. Your college, by chance, has selected me as a person. And I am just trying to tell you that I'm the right person because I'm actually doing projects of creating livelihoods for people around these forests. our idea through Sanctuary Nature Foundation. You can read the logo below on the left side. This is the organization with which I'm working. Our idea is that if we can create livelihoods for the communities who are living around the forest, then what will happen is they will become responsible for saving the plants and animals, which is nothing but biodiversity. And by doing that, we will be successful. I'll give you an example. There is a student of mine by the name of Sashank Dalvi, and he went to Nagaland about 14 years ago. And he realized that the people there are killing birds to eat. They were eating these birds. What he did was he taught them bird watching and becoming a bird guide. By becoming a bird guide, what happened was the people, the native people, started showing these birds to the tourists. By that, they started earning money. The livelihood creation was by becoming bird guides. Now they realized that instead of eating the birds, if we save these birds, then my son, my grandson, and everybody can earn money for many, many years to come by becoming a bird guide. What happened now? Instead of eating the birds, they realized that by saving the birds, we can show these birds to the tourists. And in that manner, we can earn money for many, many generations to come. I repeat, when people start deriving benefit from biodiversity, this is our success, which is what we were very much happy about. Today, we are all at the tri-junction. We are all at the tri-junction of biodiversity, climate change, and economy. The economy of the country is dependent on the natural resources. And natural resources are in the form of forest, soil, mountains, oceans, fresh water. All these are our resources which we need to save. I'm enumerating the sustainable development goals of the Environment Action Plan that has been rolled out very recently. You will say, sir, these are all good for us also. No poverty, zero hunger, good health, quality education, gender equality, clean water and sanitation. Are you all not interested in having clean water for drinking and good sanitation practice by our authorities as well as our communities, our societies, residential complexes, everybody? We need good sanitation. Affordable and clean energy, decent work, economic growth, industry. All of you are industry are interested in industry because from industry you are going to earn money. But if this industry is going to be a polluting industry, what is the use? Because very soon it will all stop and people will have no chance to develop more and more industrial projects. Reducing inequality, sustainable cities. Today in Ahmedabad, Gandhinagar, they are having smart cities, sustainable cities. And with sustainable cities only you can have a long-term plan for entire administration, responsible consumption, climate action. All these are important goals for us. Do you think that these are the problems only of environmentalists? I should think of this because I'm an environmentalist, so-called. It is a important thing for all of you, for all of us, for all citizens. What stream of education you come from does not matter. Whether you are from commerce, arts, any background, all these are important goals that we all need to understand and we all need to take into consideration. This talk would have been a very dry talk if I kept on talking about livelihoods all the time and telling you about what are the livelihoods that are being created. But I wanted to make this talk more interesting. So I have included some slides of my own, as well as one of my student. His name is Dr. Anish Andheria. He's right now the president of the Wildlife Conservation Trust. It's a trust which is giving crores of rupees to the forest department and to the communities. Okay. You can see the owner of the company, Mr. Hemendra Kothari. They are all a part of a huge, huge financial advisors, DCP, as you might know. Okay. Look at the shares and you'll come to know. Why I'm telling you all this is because why should a person like Mr. Hemendra Kothari spend crores of rupees in ecosystem services, in creating livelihoods for people, and in making the environment better? He knows very well that with people like Dr. Anish Andheria, whose photographs I'm going to share now, these are the people who can save our wildlife and can create more better environment for our people and for our decision makers to survive. So we are all living in India and we are very lucky because we have the Himalaya here with us, the Kiang. Just last month, I was in Kashmir. I'm running a project on ecosystem services in Kashmir. Very soon we are going to start. I'm going to talk about it later on also. And Himachal Pradesh, Himalaya, where you find this rare snow leopard, okay? And the Desert National Park in Run of Kutch in Gujarat, western side, where you have this, in Gujarati, we call this Jangli Gadeda, okay? But this Jangli Gadeda does not look like the Gadeda that you think of. These are the very beautiful, handsome, wild ass of Gujarat, okay? We have wild asses in Gujarat and we also have wild asses in Ladakh. These are the animals living there. Now, every slide I can talk about livelihood creation. Wildlife tourism is one of the biggest challenges today. So if I go back also and I talk about snow leopard today, in Himalaya where the snow leopard lives, there is a snow leopard conservancy program. What did they do? They trained the local people in hospitality. Okay. Since 20 years, I've gone into Ladakh and stayed with these people of Ladakh. Okay, what do they have? They have every house which has got a homestay. The husbands have been taught to become trekkers, mountaineers, so that they can take tourists to the wildlife. They can show snow leopard, they can show Himalayan ibex, Himalayan animals and so on. And the ladies have been taught to cook food and serve them in a very nice, clean environment. Look at this. The Snow Leopard Conservancy Program. They wanted to save snow leopards. What did they do as a beginning? They first did hospitality training for local people out there so that they could start homestay. By starting the homestay, the local people, the men, understood that by saving these animals and showing it to the tourists, we can earn more money rather than killing these animals for our food. The woman understood that by inviting tourists and by giving them clean bartan, clean house to stay and so on, I have gone and stayed there and this is the best example of hospitality training for tourists and earning money out of that. In Desert National Park, I can give you hundreds of examples of ecotour lodges, ecotour managers. They are taking people to desert. By taking the people to desert, they are also having programs in which there is a cultural music and dance festival. So the local people of Rajasthan, they, you know, in Jaipur and in Rajasthan, they have this puppet show. And they also have these cultural dance. You know, the Ghumar, which became very famous because of Deepika Padukone and the movie. But this Ghumar dance is a cultural activity which the tourists are shown, and from that the local people are earning money because more tourists come and they see these dance and they earn money out of that. So in the desert, they show the colorful dresses and so on, and they also show wild animals. So wildlife tourism is a big thing. Kaziranga National Park, you all know, is in Assam. I have been there. The rhino is there. It saves the grassland. It saves the wetland. But by saving the wetland, the entire Brahmaputra River is a basin where fishes are saved, where animals are saved. As the same Brahmaputra goes out, it carries along with it the nutrients for the fish and the other animals to survive. Downstream, there are fishermen. These fishermen, their livelihood is catching fish and selling it in the market. Who is creating the fish for these fishermen? The rhino is creating the fish for these fishermen. The elephants are creating the fish for the fishermen. Because when the elephants eat the grass, when the rhinos eat the plants, they are giving out dung, what you call as shit. I'm sorry, I have to use the word because that's the easy way for you to understand. When these rhinos and elephants give out the shit, the fecal matter, on that fecal matter, the nutrients are developed. These nutrients which are there are mixing in the water. On these nutrients, small plants survive, small animals survive. And from these small plants and animals, the fishes grow big. And that's how the fish is created for the fishermen to fish downstream. When Brahmaputra goes out, goes into Assam, goes into other parts of India, and that's how the rest of the people are living. Today, there are tiger sanctuaries like Ranthambore Tiger Reserve in Rajasthan, and there are several tiger reserves. There are more than about 53 project tigers in India. These forests, not just the tiger forest, but the other forests also, these forests are a source of rivers in India. How many? 600 rivers originate from the forests in India. That is why in Hindi, we have a saying, jungle nadi ki maa hai. Agar jungle bachenge, to nadiya usme se utpanna hongi. Aur ye nadiya, without river, what developmental program can you have? You cannot have factories, you can't have industries, you can't have agriculture, you can't have nuclear cooling power plants. You can have nothing without water. So, agar jal hai, to jeev hai. We all know that. Agar jal hai, to jeev hai. Isiliye jal hi jeev hai. Aur ye jal aata kahan se hai? Ye jal aata hai jangalon mein se. Kyunki jangal nadi ki maa hai. तो अगर जंगल नदी की मां है और अगर जल ही जीव है तो जीव हमारे लिए नहीं बन सकता है अगर जंगलों को हम बचा के नहीं रखेंगे. Without forest, you cannot have. That's why the tiger is called as पट्टेदार पानी का देवता. What is the name of the tiger? The tiger is called पट्टेदार पानी का देवता, which means striped forest god, striped god of the water. Striped god of the water. So the tiger is like a metaphor. The tiger can be a deer, the tiger can be a grasshopper, the tiger can be anything. All these animals which are there in the forest, they are all a part of the entire ecosystem. And each one is dependent on each other. So all these, if they are saved, we are saving the biodiversity. Same example with gaur. These gaur, they are large animals. Okay? Isko galti se log bolte hai, Indian bison. But the real name is gaur. Okay? So these gaur are present in several forests. They are also the creatures which recycle, which eat plants, and which are an important component of the entire environment. What about the bears? These gaur and the bears, they are the best tree planters in the forest. Main kya bata raha hu? Ye bhalu jo hai, aur jo gaur hai, wo alag alag prakar ke fruits khate hai. They eat the fruits. And once they eat the fruits, the seeds, ek jagah se khate hain, dusri jagah jaake wo log apne droppings, apni jo fecal matter hoti hai, apni jo shit hoti hai, uske andar se sab beej ko alag alag jagah pe jaake beej ko ye, they are planting the trees. So these are the natural farmers of the forest. Maine kya kaha? Bears and gaurs are the natural farmers. Ye kya kar rahe hain? Ye alag alag beej ko अलग अलग जगह पे जाके दे आर मूविंग अराउंड. व्हेन दे मूव अराउंड दे प्लांट दीज सीड्स इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट सो दैट मोर एंड मोर ट्रीज कैन ग्रो. एज बिट्टू सहगल माय फ्रेंड एंड आई कीप ऑन टेलिंग एवरीबॉडी, वी आर नॉट गुड ट्री प्लांटर्स. द बेयर्स, द स्क्विरल्स, द मंकीज, द गौर, दीज आर द रियल ट्री प्लांटर्स. अगर इनको हम छोड़ दें, इनको हम वक्त दें, तो ये सबसे अच्छे पेड़ का रोपण करते हैं. दे आर प्लांटिंग ट्रीज मच बेटर देन एनी ऑफ अस. सो एज आई सेड, इकोसिस्टम सर्विसेज ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट. आई मीन आई कैन कीप ऑन गिविंग यू जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज विच द फॉरेस्ट इज क्रिएटिंग, बट आई कांट गो इनटू द स्मॉल निटिग्रिटीज. आई एम गिविंग यू अ बिगर पिक्चर. सो व्हाट इज द इकोसिस्टम सर्विस ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट? नंबर वन, बायोलॉजिकल सर्विस. बायोलॉजिकल सर्विस यानी मैंने आपसे कहा, वी कैन गेट फॉडर, वी कैन गेट फर्नीचर, वी कैन ग्रो द ट्रीज फॉर आर फार्मेसी, विच मीन्स मेडिसिंस. ऑल द एलोपैथिक मेडिसिंस आर फर्स्ट हैविंग देयर ओरिजिन फ्रॉम ट्रीज, फ्रॉम प्लांट्स. लेटर ऑन In the pharmaceutical companies, we copy the important ingredient, that is chemical. We synthesize that chemical and then we produce the medicine. In the past, we have made medicine for malaria, and that plant, the tree, okay, cinchona tree, from the bark of the cinchona tree, we got the chemical. From that chemical, we produced the medicine to fight malaria. These are the biological services that the forest is giving. Hydrological service, you all know that without the forest, okay, there will be no water which will go down. If there is no forest, then the catchment area of the dam will have soil erosion. All the soil will go down, will collect in the dam, and in the dam, there will be siltation. Because of siltation, what happens is the water level in the dam, if it could hold 1 million cubic liters of water, now it can hold only 0.5 cubic liters of water. What is the meaning? The catchment area, because the soil is going down, aapko wo purani kahani malum hai, kauwe ko pani chahiye tha, to jab pani ka star niche tha, usne kankad patthar dale, aur wo star upar a gaya. Same thing happens. What is happening? Because of the erosion of the soil gets collected into the dam. It's called siltation. Because of siltation, the water holding capacity of the dam reduces. The same dam becomes defunct or non-functional in less number of years. Without forest, we can't have proper life of the dam. Today, all of us are crying for water. You go to several cities, there is no water after a few months. Because we have denuded the forest, we have cleared the forest, and these the forests are natural sponges for our fresh water. Because of the forest, the underground table of water, they are called aquifers. The aquifers are recharged because of the forest, and without that, we cannot have water over a sustainable period of time. Third, archaeological. I mean, look at the caves, the mountains, and all the Buddhist caves. In Sanjay Gandhi National Park, you have the Canary Caves. Okay? Because of the forest, the caves have been saved, or other way around, because of the caves, the forest has been saved. Okay? And archaeological, there are so many tour guides who are earning money. Not just that, the rock phases, it's called as compact basalt rock in the Western Ghats. It's one of the most important rocks. And that rock is used for building, for construction, and for several other purposes. So archaeology and geology, both are related. Recreation. So much money we spend on recreation. Adventure sports. If you don't have mountains, where will you do paragliding from? Where will you do all the hiking, mountaineering, outdoor photography, all our recreation? What about yoga, spiritual and health? You can't have recreation without some kind of a forest or a natural reserve. Education and research, very important aspect. Without education, I mean, without forest, you can't have education and research. And this research is helping us to understand not just the services of the forest, but also the ways in which we can use these forests for our own benefit. So from each of these broad headings, can you think, can you realize in each of these, there can be 200, 300 livelihoods which we can create. I can't go into the details of each livelihood, as I said, because you all can understand what are the livelihoods that can be created. I mean, just giving you an example, recreation. Okay. From recreation, you have travel agents, you have tour operators, you have hotels, you have guides, you have taxi services. Can you think of all the things which are related to recreation? And because of recreation, how many different kinds of livelihoods are created just because we are offering recreation to people? I mean, imagine in Kerala, because of tourists, you have spice shops. These are shops which are selling spices. There are shops which are selling handicrafts. There are shops which are selling paintings. Kya nahi ho sakta hai? Ek tourism is the broad heading. And under that, there are so many livelihoods which are created. So think of these as a part of the Indian and global economy. And you, as students of bookkeeping and accountancy, have to do the audit of all these ecosystem services. Today, there are scientists who are doing audit. What is audit? Profit and loss. Kitna humko profit milta hai jungalon mein se aur kitna loss hota hai. I'm sure you have heard of climate change, and through climate change, you have also heard of carbon calculation. What is carbon calculator? You need to understand that every activity of yours is either earning carbon or giving out carbon. How? Because when you breathe, carbon dioxide is given out. When you burn energy, carbon dioxide is given out. When you take a car, carbon dioxide is given out. I'm not saying that you should stop living in the city and go to the caves and live as a sadhu, mahatma, or a muni, rishi. No. What is important is that by living in the city, how can you reduce the amount of carbon that you are giving out? Here is where you can make an audit, profit and loss of carbon. Kitna carbon aap dete ho aur kitna carbon aap earn karte ho. Kaise aap carbon earn kar sakte ho? With this lecture, I am earning some carbon. Why? Because I am educating you all about carbon footprint. So all of you will be, there are more than 200 participants today. All of you will be interested in looking at a carbon calculator. Google ke upar, aap jao aur dhundo carbon calculator. Aapki family ke liye, aap carbon calculator ko use kar sakte ho. You can generate your own technological advance is too much nowadays. So you can make your own calculator and see aap carbon kahan pe jyada dete ho. AC use karne se, car use karne se, okay, कपड़े खरीदने से ज्यादा 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 क्या चीजें हैं आप अपने रोज की जिंदगी में क्या करते हो जिसके कारण आप कार्बन बाहर फेंकते हो. कार्बन कैसे अर्न कर सकते हो? पेड़ उगाने से, पेड़ की देखरेख करने से, ऐसे लोगों को लेक्चर देने से, ताकि कम लोग कार्बन ज्यादा एटमॉस्फेयर में डाले. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउ आई विल कम टू टू ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट्स वेयर आई एम इन्वॉल्व्ड इन दिस. Near Umared Karandla Wildlife Sanctuary. This is a wildlife sanctuary near Nagpur, actually very close to Umared town. Okay, there is a wildlife sanctuary. I published this paper in International Journal of Wilderness. What did we do? These are my photographs that I used for the article in the journal. We found there were people living there. We established what is called as cocoon. Now, what is cocoon? Cocoon is actually an acronym. आपको मालूम है acronym का मतलब है? हर एक अल्फाबेट का कुछ एक अलग वर्ड है. जैसे WHO, वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो WHO इज एन एक्रोनिम. सेम वे ककून इज एन एक्रोनिम. ककून स्टैंड्स फॉर कम्युनिटी ओन्ड, कम्युनिटी ऑपरेटेड नेचर कंजर्वेंसी. आई रिपीट, कम्युनिटी ओन्ड, कम्युनिटी ऑपरेटेड नेचर कंजर्वेंसी. ये मैं आपको दिखा रहा हूं एक उदाहरण के तौर पर, केस स्टडी जो मैं खुद कर रहा था सिंस लास्ट 5 years. और हम आगे जाके और भी बहुत सारे ककून एस्टेब्लिश कर रहे हैं. आई विल फर्स्ट मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स. कम्युनिटी ओन्ड यानी लोग जो है उनकी जो विरासत में रहनी चाहिए, उनकी ओनरशिप रहनी चाहिए, हमारी नहीं होनी चाहिए. कम्युनिटी ओन्ड. कम्युनिटी ऑपरेटेड मीन्स कम्युनिटी के लोग ही उसको चलाने चाहिए, कम्युनिटी ऑपरेटेड. नेचर कंजर्वेंसी. नेचर कंजर्वेंसी मीन्स ऐसी जगह जहां पे प्रकृति एक अच्छे विस्तार में है, लोग उसको ओन करते हैं, लोग उसको ऑपरेट करते हैं. हमने क्या किया? हमने 2012 और 13 में वी फाउंड फार्मर्स हु आर लिविंग नियर उमरेड आउटसाइड. दीज फार्मर्स, यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड 6-7 years अगो, मेनी फार्मर्स वर कमिटिंग सुइसाइड्स. आत्महत्या कर रहे थे. क्यों आत्महत्या कर रहे थे? क्योंकि खेती करने से उनको पैसे कुछ मिल नहीं रहे थे. खेती के अंदर कुछ उपजाऊ नहीं था. देर वॉज नो फसल, देर वॉज नो एग्रीकल्चर ईल्ड, एंड दे हैड ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ बैंक लोन्स विच दे हैड टू गिव बैक, एंड बिकॉज दे कुड नॉट पे दे वर कमिटिंग सुइसाइड्स. सैंक्चुरी नेचर फाउंडेशन फाउंड सम 32 सच फार्मर फैमिलीज. दे वर ओनिंग 100 एकर्स ऑफ लैंड. उनसे हमने कहा कि आप लैंड अपने ही नाम पे रखिए. वी डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू बाय द लैंड. वी डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू बाय द लैंड. अगेन आई एम सेइंग, आप वो जमीन अपने नाम पे ही रखिए. हु वर दीज? दीज वर फार्मर्स. उनसे कहा कि हम आपको जो आपके फार्मिंग में से आपको लास्ट ईयर जितने पैसे मिल रहे थे, हम उतने आपको हर साल देंगे. उनको जो पैसे मिल रहे थे वो, आप अब यहाँ पे फार्मिंग भी मत कीजिए, कुछ भी मत कीजिए. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड, स्लोली ऑन दैट फार्म लैंड ईयर आफ्टर ईयर ग्रासेस स्टार्टेड ग्रोइंग. ओके, ग्रासेस स्टार्टेड ग्रोइंग. दीज आर द फार्मर्स विद बिट्टू सहगल इन 2012-13. ओके, एरिया बिकेम रीवाइल्डेड. रीवाइल्डेड मतलब पुनर्विकास, फिर से वहां पे जंगल का पुनर्जंगल का निर्माण, रीवाइल्डिंग, फिर से जंगल को उत्पादन करना, रीवाइल्डिंग. व्हाई डिड वी डू रीवाइल्डिंग? बिकॉज दिस लैंड वॉज नॉट केपेबल ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग एनी क्रॉप्स, नॉट केपेबल, नॉट सूटेबल फॉर एग्रीकल्चर. ओके, प्लीज माइंड यू, we did not change a well established agricultural farm into a forest. We made a non-productive land which was not producing crops back to rewilding. These are the people of the village Mured Karandla, the farmers and their families. Many such families are there. Okay, slowly unke zameen ke upar ghaas ugne ko lag gaye. घास के बाद में पेड़ उगने को लग गए. 5-6 साल में उधर फिर से छोटा छोटा जंगल या स्मॉल काइंड ऑफ ग्रासलैंड्स एंड फॉरेस्ट स्टार्टेड रीअपियरिंग. ओके, ऑल्सो फाउंड आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग नेचर एजुकेशन फॉर देम. ट्रेन द यंगस्टर्स टू बिकम नेचर गाइड्स. मेनी ऑफ देम वी ट्रेन देम टू बिकम जीप गाइड्स. वी क्रिएटेड लाइवलीहुड फॉर देम. क्योंकि अगर खेती बाड़ी नहीं करेंगे तो पैसे कैसे कमाएंगे? एक तो हम जो पैसे दे रहे थे उनको सीएसआर फंडिंग के अंदर से, वो उनको पैसे मिल रहे थे, लेकिन कितने साल तक हम पैसे दे सकेंगे? आस्ते आस्ते दे मस्ट बिकम सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग. सो वी टॉट देम लाइवलीहुड क्रिएशन के द्वारा स्किल्स. एडीज को हमने और फॉरेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट ने सिखाया बैंगल, लैक बैंगल मेकिंग, मोम की बंगड़ियां बनाना. ओके, मोम की बंगड़ियां बनाना. इसके अलावा लेडीज को हमने सिखाया पापड़, आचार, ये सब चीजें बनाना. We created livelihood for the local people. Who is benefiting now out of that? They realized that tiger ko bachane se, tourist aayenge wahan pe. Tourist aayenge to unko aamdani milengi, aur wo aamdani se wo bahut sara guzara kar sakte hain aage aane wale generations ke liye bhi, for future generations also. So, what they realized was that in the 10 years ago in the past, 10 years ago in the past, there were people who were dying. So they used to call tiger as Yamdut. After 10 years, what happened? The same tiger became karta dharta for the earning money. So tiger became their annadata. Now they are saying, jo Yamdut tha, tiger, wo aaj hamara annadata ban gaya. The tiger is giving us money to earn, and because of that, we are having लाइवलीहुड क्रिएशन. अब अगर उनकी खेती में टाइगर आ जाता है तो बोलते हैं कोई बात नहीं, ये हमारा देवता है, इसी के लिए तो हमको पैसे मिल रहे हैं आजकल, इसको देखने को लोग आते हैं तो हमारा जो गांव है उसको पैसे मिल रहे हैं. आई टेकन माई स्टूडेंट्स एमएससी बायोडाइवर्सिटी 3 years अगो. यू कैन सी आई एम स्टैंडिंग इन द जीप. दिस इज माई स्टूडेंट विद हिज कैमरा एंड हियर इज द टाइगर. इफ यू कैन सी, यहाँ पे टाइगर खड़ा है उसी एरिया में, उसी जगह पे जहाँ पे तो खेती कर रहे थे. और ये देखो टाइगर के फुटप्रिंट है उनकी लैंड के ऊपर, उनकी जमीन के ऊपर. ये एक लड़का है वहां पे सुभाष करके, वो घूम रहा था. उसको मैंने कहा सुभाष अकेले मत घूमो, अभी टाइगर वहां पे घूम रहे हैं. इस स्टडी नंबर 2, दारा दाचीगम कश्मीर. ये जो दाचीगम नेशनल पार्क है कश्मीर के अंदर, श्रीनगर से 23 किलोमीटर दूर है. वहां पे 2 ट्राइबल रहते हैं, गुज्जर और बकरवाल. ये गुज्जर और बकरवाल जो है ये भेड़ बकरी गाय चराते थे, चराते हैं, लेकिन वो चराते चराते जंगलों में घूमते थे और पेड़ पहाड़ों में घूमते थे. अब हम उनको क्या कर रहे हैं? अब हम उनको बोल रहे हैं आप जंगल में मत घूमिए, आप जो आपके भेड़ बकरियां हैं उनको घास उगाकर आपके घर में ही उनको खिलाइए और आप हमारे गाइड्स बनिए. गाइड किसके लिए? ट्रेकिंग के लिए, एक्सपेडिशंस के लिए, हाइकिंग के लिए, बर्ड वॉचिंग के लिए, कैंप्स अरेंज करने के लिए. तो इससे उनको लाइवलीहुड क्रिएशन कर रहे हैं और उससे एक दुगना हमारा एक मकसद, वी आर गेटिंग अ सेकंड बेनिफिट आउट ऑफ दैट. जब वो भेड़ बकरियों को जंगल में लेके जाते थे तो उनकी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होती थी बैर के साथ में, भालू के साथ में. एक ऐसा भी किस्सा बना है कि एक आदमी को बैर ने अटैक किया और दो दिन के बाद लोगों ने गुस्से में आकर एक भालू को जला दिया था. तो ये सब स्टॉप करने के लिए, ओके, ये सब रिड्यूस करने के लिए हम उनको सिखा रहे हैं कि आप घर बैठे क्या कमा सकते हैं, आपकी औरतें और मर्द जो है वो हमें बर्ड वॉचिंग, नेचर वॉक, ट्रेल्स, ट्रैक्स, कैंपिंग, ये सब के अंदर हमको हेल्प कर सकते हैं. इसके साथ में ऊन की बुनाई, छोटी छोटी कॉटेज इंडस्ट्री, छोटे छोटे हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स बना सकते हैं जिससे लोगों को हम बेच सकते हैं उनके द्वारा. एंड दिस इज हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट. मैं गए मार्च में भी गया था और ये फरवरी मार्च में भी जा चुका था, फिर से मैं जुलाई महीने में गया था. आई एम वेरी हैप्पी कि इसके तौर पे, बिकॉज ऑफ दिस आई एम गोइंग टू कश्मीर सो ऑफन. तुम लोग ट्रेकिंग, आई मीन तुम लोग जाते थे हॉलीडेज के लिए, मैं जाता हूँ काम के लिए, क्योंकि मेरा काम ही हॉलीडे है मेरे लिए. तो ये सब जंगलों में मैं घूमते रहता हूँ. अभी चार दिन के पहले मैं सातपुड़ा टाइगर रिजर्व गया था और वहीं से वापस आया हूँ. मेरी आधी जिंदगी से ज्यादा जंगलों में और नेचर रिजर्व्स में बीती है, क्योंकि मैं ये लोगों के साथ में रहता हूँ और हमेशा इसीलिए मैं खुश रहता हूँ, क्योंकि ये सब चीजों के लिए आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट आई गो अराउंड एंड टीच पीपल हाउ टू क्रिएट लाइवलीहुड्स अमंगस्ट पीपल. आई अंडरस्टैंड इकोनॉमी मच बेटर देन द साइंस टीचर्स आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, बिकॉज एवरी डे आई एम थिंकिंग अबाउट द पीपल. मैं ये सोचता हूँ लोगों को इसमें से क्या फायदा मिल सकता है हमेशा. If you have any questions, I'll be very happy to answer.
Thank you, Pravesh sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, really, you have given an insight about real bookkeeping, I can say. How we can be a real businessman. So earlier, we were just thinking about that there is a problem and there is just a problem and how to solve the problem. As the way that you have given an example of farmers, that they were committing suicide and all things. So we were constantly thinking on one problem and problem. We were not having any idea about how to get the solution. And here it's like you all came out with an ideology, something else, which obviously farmers wouldn't have thought about. So this is what is creativity. This is what is bookkeeping, I can say, whereby you create business.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Business and means of earning can be created so many. I'll give you one more example. In Pench Tiger Reserve, we have a resort. And outside the resort, there are farmers. In some of the farmers, in between their entire agricultural crop, there is a machan. On the machan, on the top of the machan, there is a bed, there is a toilet, there is a machardani, and there is no roof. Upar roof nahi hai. Foreigners come there, and they spend what is called as star bed. It is called star bed. आप उसके अंदर जाके रुको, आप तारे देखो, और वो खेत के अंदर अगर कोई animals आके घूमते हैं, पंछी आके घूमते हैं, वो आप देखो. Resort के अंदर से जो farmer है, उसको पैसे मिलते हैं, tourist को एक रात बिताने के लिए, जो बाहर से कितने dollars खर्च करके आते हैं. राजस्थान में हम टूरिस्ट को इनवाइट करते हैं कि आप बंजर नदी के पास आओ, राजस्थानी खाना खाओ, फोक डांस देखो और लोकल ट्राइबल लोगों के साथ में इंटरैक्ट करो. ये उनका एक यूनिक एक्सपीरियंस बनता है. ऐसे हजारों हैं जो हम रोज करते रहते हैं लोगों के लिए. अभी अभी आप मानेंगे नहीं, यू विल नॉट बिलीव इट, दो घंटे पहले हमारा एक इंटरेक्शन था इंडसइंड बैंक के साथ में, जो अपने फॉरेनर्स और टूरिस्ट जो आते हैं उनके लिए यूनिक एक्सपीरियंस देने के लिए हमने उनसे 50 अलग तरीके बताए जिससे उनको यूनिक एक्सपीरियंस मिल सकते हैं. ऐसे ही ये बिजनेस है. आप सब बच्चे जो मैं ऊपर जो नाम देख रहा हूँ, तन्मय है, अरिन है, आप लोग सब, यू हैव टू नाउ क्रिएट बिजनेस फ्रॉम एनवायरमेंट. You are all the future generation. You will have much more ideas. आप तो TikTok और इसके ऊपर सब बहुत सारा देखते रहते हो. आपके पास बहुत your mind is much more innovative than our mind. Create business models and make people earn money. If people will, ये मत सोचो तुमको कितना फायदा होगा. तुमको फायदा होने ही वाला है. जब लोग कमाएंगे तो तुमको भी पैसे मिलेंगे.
Absolutely right, sir. Your model has explained the same thing. Whereby you earn and let us also earn. It's like give and give, like benefiting both the individuals.
Absolutely.
So it's really a great insight, sir, into about the environment and associated environment with bookkeeping. That is business. Students, if you are having a question, you can use the chat box feature. Right, you can type your questions over there. If any of the student has to answer the question, has to raise any question, then they can raise their hand.
See, I'm laughing. I'm laughing because one student, Yogesh, has written that he has heard my song on senior citizen competition because I had won an award in that.
Oh, great. So if I ask you to sing that song, is it possible?
Oh.
So that award-winning song, obviously, even we would like.
Award-winning song was Savan ka mahina pavan kare sor jiyara re jhume se jaise ban mana che mor. सावन का महीना पवन करे सोर जियरा रे झूमे से जैसे बन माना चे मो